Please welcome Greg Jacobs.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. Or as they would say in German, Servus, which means hello in a Bavarian kind of way. So the guys in the office always say, Servus, Servus. I want to walk you through a few things that we do about our brand today. I'll walk you through some of the media side of the media company, which is Red Bull Media House. It's funny that when he mentioned that, those bios always kind of embarrass me. But when I won the Emmy, I won that for the one sale I had to make at NASCAR. I'd been there almost a year, and I had not sold a thing. If I owned a mortuary, nobody would have died. And I got up that morning, and my grandfather used to always say, get up, dress up, and show up. And I went, and I pitched the client, and the client said, yeah, we'll do that. I said, it's a 38-part series. It's $175,000 an episode. He kept saying, yeah, we'll do that. We'll do that. So it was kind of nice. We won the Emmy on one project, one sale I had to do to save my ass at NASCAR, and that was successful. So we're going to show you a trailer about speed riding. A lot of you actually participate in this sport, and this is part of a series called Unridables. It's the top 1% of our athletes will do projects around like this. So this is called speed riding. Tonight at 9 p.m., if you give us 46 minutes of your time, we will show you the whole piece. So boys, roll the tape.
Growing up in Alaska, I'd always stare out at the mountains, dreaming of what it would take to ski every single peak. Alaska has been the playground for big mountain skiing and snowboarding for over 20 years. One of the last places in North America where the glaciers still dominate the landscape.
The inspiration for staying on the ground more and making more aggressive ski turns, you know, really was influenced by Antoine and those boys over there in the Chamonix area that were really opening our eyes to what was possible in the mountains.
He had the idea of going to ski somewhere where the best skiers of the world cannot go. This built something that became speed riding. At the beginning, it was speed flying, but then we had to look for another name because it was not flying with skis, it was skiing with a canopy.
Whole life waiting for this moment, an opportunity to pioneer and ski mountains that were previously thought unrideable.
Stand by, John. Leave me to lift. Negative, hold your position. John, just stand by right there.
One word, rad. I want to say thank you very much for having us as part of the Colt Gathering. My first time to Banff. I spent a lot of years in Aspen, Colorado, so it kind of reminds me of home that way. But we're just excited to be here today. Hope you guys can join us for the movie tonight. So without further ado, let's get into it. So what you saw there was engaging with the audience. You know, content like that, as Sumner Redstone would always say, content is king. But how do you engage an audience? How do you keep their attention or a loyal attention? Well, you can do a couple of things. You can telemarket, or those annoying calls at dinner time. You can hope to get their attention, or you can buy their attention. But you can also produce content and put the brand first. What we did with this property, like our others, is we put our athlete and our brand first. John DeVore is one of the main athletes in the piece, and we were on a mission to fascinate and inspire. John actually grew up in Alaska, and skiing was his very first love. But then he got into jumping off stuff. So he would huck himself off of cliffs, out of a helicopter, and these guys are what we call our Red Bull Air Force. And we did a piece of content earlier in the year where we actually had them over the skyline, over the World Trade One, over the skyline of New York, and they actually landed on a barge in the middle of the Hudson River. And so this is the kind of stuff that engages our audience and keeps them compelled. So it's attention. How do you reach an audience? You have to have an authentic brand. What you'll notice as you look at these slides, I'm going to ask you a little quiz downstream, but it's all about the brand and less so about the product. And then it's relevant content. Because going back to April 1st, 1987, we had no brand. We had really no money, didn't have much outlet. And so Dietrich Mateschitz, our founder, launched Red Bull on April 1st, 1987. And we did the oldest trick in the book. We started sampling. And so we would sample, and there's an on-premise account for us. And what we did is by sampling, we basically gave the product to the people who needed it, the skier, the windsurfer, the skateboarder, and they found that the product worked. The brand led, but the product worked. So our heroes. Throughout the years, we compiled a list of athletes, musicians, and artists worldwide. These are our opinion leaders. They, through their messages, is where we drive the story. We give them wings for people and ideas, and they then go out and broadcast our message for us. We also then program content from linear to digital to theatrical, and what we've noticed is on our YouTube channel, we actually gone to a new way of doing it where we do episodic programming. So we'll do 6 by 3.5 minutes, and we're seeing how well the audience is engaged, that they're actually staying there for the whole 3.5 or 4 minutes. And we actually look at that very carefully to make sure we program our web content to just that TRT, total running time, that they will stay engaged with. Our YouTube channel, we're luckily know, is strong for us. We have 4 million subs, and we just hit 1 billion views last month. The events have also become happenings for us. So as we put the events out there, we try to bring the audience along. So an idea of the different events that we do 1,000 a year throughout the across the globe. And then we do Flying Day. It's called Flugtag, and that's German for Flying Day. If we give wings to people and ideas, why don't you build yourself a craft and see if you can actually fly that craft? So they launch off of piers all throughout the world, and this is one of our events in Long Beach, where we have a lot of consumer engagement, again, putting the brand first rather than the product. The Red Bull Signature Series. I went to NBC 4 years ago, and we talked about doing a co-partnership or co-venture for SIG Series. And you think of X Games, you think of Dew Tour, you think of SIG Series. We try to make this the most progressive action sports series on television. And then we take this content, it has a linear first window on NBC weekend day part, then we move it to our YouTube channel and across our other channels. Again, using owned and third-party channels as best we can to drive that long monetization stream and also to drive visibility. At the end of the day, it is revenue. We're a media company. It is revenue that we look for, but it's also eyeballs. And those two things combined together is your KPI. We also have Red Bull Sound Select. It's one of our popular music platforms where we have the artists engage directly with the consumer. We actually, with Sound Select, we're able to give a lot of artists that otherwise wouldn't be discovered a chance to be discovered. It's been very popular for us. Then we have a new field of play called eSports. That's the new phrase everybody's using, eSports. So it's, of course, gaming, and gaming is very strong, and our product and this work really well together, hand-eye coordination, all that goes into gaming. So we launched Red Bull Battlegrounds, and it's been successful for us. So it's, again, it's having the right events with the right feel at the right time with the right consumer and audience. But at the end of the day, we're storytellers, and it's all about telling that story in an authentic way that drives engagement, time spent viewing. That's key. Because from the money side, I can charge a higher CPM if they're engaged or they have high time spent viewing. That's the trick. We also engage to a very coveted 18 to 34 male. So we have an elusive audience that we try to pull in, and again, it works well for our advertisers and our partners. Content marketing and native advertising are a buzz right now. And I love this line on top. I love this sponsored content. It's got to be authentic that way. And these are the buzzwords that are being tossed around, but there is a way to do it, and any marketer can do it in an authentic way. You need proper budget, you need creative thinking, and if you have opinion leaders within your system, use and leverage those opinion leaders. So I ask you, do you know your brand's attributes? Ours is giving wings to people's ideas. If you look on the can, it says vitalizing body and mind. Those are attributes. We always want to be authentic. But can you clearly internally define those attributes? Can anybody within your team or within your company know exactly what the company stands for? From the guy driving the distribution truck to the receptionist to the CEO. What about your consumer? That's key. Does your consumer know your brand attributes? And can they recite those? Because brand attributes don't change. However, campaigns do. The coveted child in our building is the brand. The brand is always first. So, media company. We've been producing content since about 88 or so. We had to get the company off the ground and going, and then we started producing content. So we've captured all this content. We own and control all of our content across the board. So when we hire a production company, we own the content. That allows us to launch our content across all platforms without having to seek third-party rights. It's key. Ownership of content is key. So the media company launched 20 years later, 2007, in the media capital of the world, Salzburg, Austria. I got hired in December of 10 to come on board to start a distribution company, or the distribution side of it. And I was told by one of the founders, hey, Greg, you know what, you're gonna start Red Bull Media House in the US, and it's only the second largest market on the planet to start in. So we did that knowing that Salzburg was the largest market. Anyway, we started in 10. I walked in, and it was the proverbial garage. I walked in, and there's these rows and rows of content that had not been pushed out or monetized. And it was so exciting those first few days, just trying to get my mind around what I had to sell. So Red Bull Media House, and this is a quick clip.
When people see the places we're riding right now, there's just no comparison.
I'm doing what I love, and you know, if you're doing what you want to do all the time, then you're happy. You're not going to work every day wishing you were doing something else.
You just gotta go. There's no way around it. You just gotta show people that you're not scared and you love that feeling.
Florida is known as the epicenter of wakeboarding.
The world's best slopestyle horse ever.
64 of the world's toughest skaters go head-to-head.
Travis Rice's supernatural event is the next chapter in winter's hottest sport.
Red Bull Rampage is basically what everyone is aiming to win.
The highest level of mountain biking you can do.
The long-awaited premiere of Where the Trail Ends is finally here.
I think it's just human nature to want to explore.
The fifth stop of the Red Bull Cliff Diving World Series in Boston. Watch out behind.
It's not a competition where you can play it safe. The DJs got to impress everybody.
Thank you. Lederhosen. That's how you get the women.
This is Red Bull Battlegrounds.
Red Bull Land Seattle.
Red Bull Flugtag Philadelphia.
We love you, Miami!
Red Bull Flugtag San Francisco 2012.
You'll see there we actually have the live streaming rights for Lollapalooza, Bonnaroo, and Austin City Limits, and that's on our digital platform called Red Bull TV, which is an over-the-top tile. I don't want to call it an app, but a tile. Apple TV, connected TVs with Samsung, Roku, etc. So if you get a chance, if you have an Apple TV, check it out. The channel actually is quite cool, and we have live streaming rights just to enhance our portfolio. We don't own Lollapalooza, but we have the live streaming rights, which is important. So that takes me to the strategic value chain. Again, it's authentic content. The audience will know who delivered them the programming. Trust me, they will know. You don't have to have can in hand. Relevant media properties or products. Third party and owned channels. You can do a windowing strategy. If you want to pump it on your own channel first and then window it out to a YouTube or a third party channel, fine. But if you're looking to monetize your content, you're gonna find that value in a third party license deal until you can sell against your .com or against your own YouTube channel. We actually, as of 3 months ago, are in the coveted place with YouTube where we can actually sell against our channel, a direct sell against our channel only. Whereas YouTube was able to sell against all channels, they can't sell against one channel. We can now sell, my team can sell against just our YouTube channel. It allows me to sell it for a higher CPM. So the windowing of a content is very important to us on how we strategize that out. And we have to look at the revenue versus eyeball versus getting traffic for our own channels. And then, of course, it's revenue. And we built the media company as a company, as a profit-centric company, and that's what we continue to do. Now, we do get marketing from it, we get eyeballs from it, but at the end of the day, we're there to generate revenue with the media company. Premium content, sports and adventure, music and lifestyle, and esports. Again, it's that 18 to 34-year-old male, and that's what allows us to go into Fox and do a Fox deal with our World Series, an NBC deal with SIG Series, or an opportunity with Outside or what have you. Feature films. We do a lot of feature films. On Any Sunday, actually, is the number one doc on iTunes right now. And that came out, we had the premiere of that October 22nd. And by the way, Derek Westland, stand up for a second. Derek is the director and company owner for Free Ride Entertainment and did Unwritables. And he also did On Any Sunday. So we take our feature films, and you may say that packaged media is dead. Well, it's slowly dying, but it's not dead yet. So of course, packaged media, we do a 3-in-1. We give them a Blu-ray, standard DVD, as well as electronic download, all within the packaging. But then of course, I window it out to iTunes and all the EST platforms, and we direct sell it that way. For On Any Sunday, though, we did a theatrical premiere. The first time Red Bull has ever done a theatrical premiere, we did that, and then I had to protect a 90-day window from releasing theatrically with Regal Cinemas to when we could release day and date for the packaged media and the EST. So that's our film business. We make companion episodic series from our films that then allow us to go to different platforms and embark to the films. Of course, we do documentaries. Global Rallycross is a property that we do as well, and then our web series have been very successful for us. So media channels, we have a print magazine still, and you may say, boy, packaged media and print, it all combines together. But what it allows us to do is I could take one partner, let's take a Dodge or take a Samsung, and I could put them through a 360 degree, from events to the magazine, to signature series, to our Fox series, to our own channels, to our YouTube channel, and allows me to give a portfolio of opportunity to a partner. This actually, believe it or not, is the fastest growing men's magazine today, the Red Bulletin. Again, our third party channels, our YouTube channel, and our Facebook and Instagram. Then Red Bull TV, and you see some of the platforms that it's on there. And then finally, our .com. So using all the channels to distribute the content and most importantly, monetize the content through that whole cycle. You probably all saw this at some point. On October 14th, 2012, Felix Baumgartner jumped from 128,000 feet. And that was, of course, Red Bull Stratos. We had a production studio in space. We had global distribution, where we had 77 live TV broadcast partners and 280 web partners. We sold it to premium sponsors, and we had engagement, 9 million tweets. But let me back up for a second. I've been in television sales my entire life. When I found out Stratos was, it was a 7-year project, and the reason for Stratos is very simple. With private space travel, can you extract a human body from a craft at a certain altitude, and can the human body sustain the speed of sound? With Virgin Galactic and with SpaceX, with that private space travel, can we actually escape at some point? The human body had never broken the speed of sound voluntarily. Involuntarily, when their fighter jet would break up around them and they were forcing that. So we figured that Felix wanted to try it. He's one of our very first athletes. And so we gave him the tools to do it. We own the entire ecosystem. There's a production truck in that capsule. His whole thing, everything was owned by Red Bull. And I took the property to Eileen O'Neill. At the time, she was running Discovery Channels. And I walked in, and it's all about, can you say it in one sentence? I said, Eileen, we have a guy jumping from space. She says, I'm in. She goes, well, when is it going to happen? This is going to be great. We can bark to it. We don't know when it's going to happen. Well, where are you doing it? Roswell, New Mexico? Oh. The reason Roswell is because there's a cone of airspace there where commercial air travel can't go through. So there's a missile site there. So Roswell has this cone of protected airspace. So when his capsule would go up, we didn't know where it would really go, but within this radius, we'd be protected. And then we had to clear 100 different ranchers, because if he landed on one of their ranches, we had to make sure they knew about it. So he ascended up, of course, jumped, broke the speed of sound. It was the 9 million concurrent views on YouTube. It was the most engaged digital piece of content ever. The Royal Wedding, I think, had maybe 1.5 or 2 million concurrents. We had 9. There were 65 people in San Francisco with YouTube removing things around the internet because we used 20% of the global internet bandwidth for Stratos. And then back to Eileen. I said, we don't know when it's going to happen, Eileen. I said, it's going to be 3 o'clock in the morning Roswell time, and I'll have to call you and say, okay, turn off your channel and put it on. And she did. It was the highest rated show, non-prime, in Discovery's history. She dedicated 4 hours of air to it. And then Discovery has a sister channel called Velocity. It was the highest rated program there. And then, of course, it had 52 million views on YouTube. A very successful product for us. But again, we did it because of the science. We didn't do it just to huck him from space. We wanted to do it for science. And it created an everlasting moment. But the thing about Red Bull is, it's funny because I remember that Sunday, 14th, October. It's actually my 42nd birthday. And I thought, okay, this is going to be great. We're going to go into, at NASCAR, when a team wins, they have a big company lunch the next day and it's fanfare. We barely talked about it the next day. All we said around the building was, what's next? What are we going to do next? And that's the level of passion and intensity, if you will, at Red Bull, always looking for the next thing to do. Our World Series, and this is where I want to pause. Have you seen one photo of the product yet? No, it's all been brand. Because when the brand comes first, you turn brand lovers into can buyers. And brand lovers will engage. I love this one that Susie Smith says. Red Bull commercials make me want to do some awesome shit. Believe in yourself. Another awesome commercial during the NBA Finals. And then the video inspires me to want to achieve my goals and chase my dreams, even if it means challenging myself. This is engagement. This is not paid. This is all earned. And that's where they engage. So then across our portfolio of properties, we have a soccer team in New York. We have the air races. We've got Crash Dice. Netflix is one of our partners. And all of this turns brand lovers into brand buyers. Oh. Well, I'm not the best at animation, apparently. So I was really going to end on a high note here and give you guys 5 rules to live by. And the animation was going to be really good. It was going to go back and forth, really nice. I worked on the plane yesterday, and I was so impressed. I had to show one of the flight attendants, look what I just did. Look how I just did this. So kind of bummed now. So be relevant and authentic. Authentic, authentic, authentic. Surprise and innovate. Be consistent. If you put a campaign out there, have enough willpower and budget to keep that campaign always on. We try to be somewhere every day on some platform with something. And it's actually easy to do if you just think it through. So always be on. Be the story. It's all about characters and storytelling. If you do that, the audience will come, they'll stay engaged, and I promise you, they'll remember who brought them that piece of content and inspire sharing. And I think that's my last slide. So thank you very much.